Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. We are from Group 4 and our topic today is the application of case grammar to translation. Before we start our presentation, let me introduce our members. I'm Dinda Wajhani as moderator and there are Nirva Indani, Lisa Novitasari, Sharifa Zakia, Adi Furqan Maulana, Zalsa Aulia Nur Humaira, and the last is Farrell Rainier Xavier. For the first speakers, will be presented by Nirva Indani.
Okay, thanks to moderator. The first material is introduction. Grammar is the skeleton of the text. Vocabulary or written sense, lexis, it's a flash and collections. The tendon that connect the one of the other. Grammar gives you the general and the main fact about a text. Statement, question, request, purpose, reason, condition, time, place, though, feeling, and certain. Grammar indicate who does what to whom, why, where, when, and how. Lexis is narrow and sharper. It describes object, animate, inanimate, abstract. Action include the process and status, and the qualities orally, nouns, verb, adjective, and adverbs.
Okay, in this chapter, we want to show how knowledge of some aspect of case grammar may be useful to the translator and therefore constitutes a part of translation theory. The distribution are first, relationship between the verb and their satellites. Second is translation of verbs, missing verbs. Third is case partners. And the last is semantic relationship to verb.
Okay, the next part, the translation of case gaps. In this part, it's divided into four categories. First, mandatory, if target language requires syntax, and if source language, text is ambiguous. Second, supplementary, information that is added and it is not part of the text. Third, implied. It is semantic to provide logic. To happen require time and place, and to behave requires a manner. La croûte, one word represents a hole the earth crushed. Le groupe as the group of students. And the last, optimal, semantic and stylistic. Extra information that is not close to be sentenced. This information could be somewhere in the text.
Okay, the next is contrast chose in translation. Number one, valence. Valence is referred to the numbers of core arguments that are part of a verb's morphosynthetic structure. Identify valence. Three valence verbs give is the giver, the given, and the give. And the last fills in gaps with three valence verb only if required. Various types of case partner. At the beginning, we called identify case partner based on grammatical terms, nominative, vocative, and subject-object. And later is identity, alterity, and finality. And then agent type, instrumental, the type, factitive, locative, patient, and benefactive. And with verbs, again, what is protest? In for of what is what one, to or from what place is go, for how long is last, away from what is run, under what is cover. And the last is hospitality verbs, is invite, welcome, bid, and last. Easy, bro.
Okay, next, the translation of missing verb. Analyzing a sentence, a clause, or verbless compound in manner that demonstrates the central position of the verb. Using nominal inflation, segmental inflation is increasing. There is a rise in inflation or inflation is under increase. Use of verbless translation. The eber Diedrich, but Diedrich was waiting for him. This was Diedrich's opportunity.
Okay, for the next material is some related issue. One, translator must demonstrate its sentence purpose, an addiction, a detail, an example, a contrast, an opposition, a reservation, an aside, an afterthought, a consequence. Number two, consequence is demonstrated with moreover on the other hand indeed.
Case partner objective and nouns. There are a large number of adjectives formed from verbs that imply case partners. Adjectives formed from verbs denote qualities or roles than single actions. Example, responsible, friends watch leech or for, protective or against, decisive and anticipatory. Equative adjectives signal a similar or identical object. Example, different, equal, similar, same, analogous, other, alike, parallel, equivalent, identical, and imitative. Adjective whose meaning is clarified only in context. Symptomatic could mean produce symptoms or be a symptom. Adjective which have implicit case partners, unless another case partner, example, greedy or food, debris or profit, and journey or struggle, eroding the jargonizing process which incidentally restores case partner.
The last material is the remark of test year. 1. 4-page metatext. 2. Pioneering study on the relation between case grammar and translation. 3. Maya texts. Deep translation which have to be retold rather than apply mechanically. 4. Mel blank. 5. Tend to be dogmatic in setting out equivalence, ignoring alternatives. 6. Tesnier chapter is brilliant and stimulating, his translation principle governing the passage from paratexis to hypotexis goes beyond constructive linguistics toward translation theory.
Okay, that's all from our presentation. Thank you for watching. Wassalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh.